Hello, this is Chad Lehman. This is a quick video to show you how to build our Raindrop Switch. The Raindrop Switch is a project of Makers Making Change, which has a library of open source assistive technology that you can build yourself. The Raindrop Switch is one of our easier projects to build, and you can find more about this device, including the instructions to 3D print it, where to buy the components, and all the assembly instructions right on our website, makersmakingchange.com. Search for the Raindrop Switch in our assistive device library. So this video is just meant to help walk you through the build instructions. Fairly minimal bill of materials. You're going to have the 3D printed base and top, the switch that will go on the inside, as well as a mono cable. You're going to want a mono cable. If you have cables around, there's just usually the tip and the sleeve. If you have a stereo where there's another ring in there, you can solder those wires together, but your life is certainly easier if you just have mono cable. So let's walk you through. So first we're going to prepare our switch components. I'm going to use flush cutters here. Yeah, so I have these legs. I'm going to straighten out all four of them. There we go. And I'm going to cut off two of the legs, as well as these little knobs. So when I have those pieces cut, you can just test. This will should fit nice and flat and snug right in the base there. Now we'll glue that in a minute. So with my mono cable here, you can get a longer mono cable cut in half. You get enough for two switches. So I'm gonna use my wire strippers here. Strip off a couple centimeters. And then from there, I'll strip off a bit of the insulating wire on the inside. So here we go. There we go. So you can see you're going to have these braids here. I'm going to twist and thread these together. There we go. So I have those two sort of bits. And then I'm going to strip about half of this. What you don't want is these two, this piece and that part of the wire to touch. That'll complete the switch, making your button relevant. This looks a little bit thinner here, so let's try the 24 gauge. There you go. Okay. So, mistake that I've seen a few people make, they solder this on before they put it through here. So let's get that in before I make that boo-boo again myself. So I'll put it through this lead hole. Sorry, put this lead hole. And now it comes through here. Now I'm just gonna pull this through a lot. Kind of stop the weight of the cable from pulling this off of my site. Now on our website, we do have a little 3D printing jig that some people find helpful in soldering. You can also just use some tape to kind of keep things in place, or a third hand. There's, you know, a few different ways you can go about this. I'm going to try tape this time. Stop the cable from moving around. I don't want it to. No, I'm kind of holding it in place. Painter's tape. There we go. I get this little twist. Now, in preparing this, a little trick that I've found is if I hold that sort of cable piece underneath it, take my needle nose pliers, take this cable that's so nicely wrapped around itself. Oops, don't want that one in there. There we go. The same over here. Okay, so I have my iron heating up here. Some solder, there we go. So it's gonna clean my tip a bit, retin it. I'm gonna walk the solder along that part here. Here we go. Same thing. There we go. Nice, just solder. Add some solder on the top here as well. Make sure you got a nice solid connection to the cables. There we go. Okay, soldered on well. Looks good. Straighten this out. Separate these little bits here. There we go. Yeah, that's good. I don't see any loose strands kind of going from one bit to the other there. I want to make sure that doesn't short at all. If there are little loose strands, you know, you can cut those little pieces. Don't worry, we're getting every little loose wire connected. You can always snip out the extra little pieces of wire. Here we go. Slide this in. Now, the next bit will be kind of using the glue gun, glues and paste. Now, you know, the glue gun can give you different mileage depending on the quality of your air gun. Or a heat gun. Glue gun. Sorry, glue gun. Now I have a fairly cheap dollar store glue gun. It works well. It can get a little stringy. So while I let this heat up, let's keep that in mind. So there's three parts we're going to glue. We're going to glue this switch into the bottom of the case. We're going to glue this top onto the switch. That's the tricky one because you don't want to get too much glue where it kind of drips into the switch and causes the glue in a connected position. And then we're going to add additional glue here. And this is just really a strain relief that stops the cable from getting ripped or pulled off the components if someone picks it up. Should never pick or pull the cable by the cable, but we know it happens. So that glue can help provide some strain relief. So when or if that does happen, it doesn't become catastrophic. So ruin the switch. Okay, let's see. Go. Okay, so I'm going to add some glue into here. I'll just heating up still. There we go. Okay. Go pushing that down, get nice and flat in there. I'm gonna fill the channel here first. The instructions have doing the cap first, but I'm just making sure my glue gun's flowing nice and warm so I don't leave myself stranded. A little bit of that. Glue off here, scrape out some tape. Okay, and so this is the part where some people get a little over vicious. I'm gonna put a little bit of glue into there, pull that out, and while it's still hot, get my cap straight in there, straight down. Just hold that in for a few seconds, let it cool. There we go. I think I have a completed Raindrop Switch. But let's find out. Another little great project on the Maker's Maker Change website is our Switch Tester. If you don't have a Switch adapted toy or something to test this on, it's a very simple build. No PCB board required. Plug this in. There we go. Push around the edges. Seems to work well. There we go. That's how you build a Raindrop Switch.